to be part of this review. Welcome to High Five Wrestling.
I am DW, Cavalier of the YWC.
I am Chicago Ted.
And all right, so here
you can't dance at all. Don't ever do that again.
I am. I'm in a good mood. Let's see, Brutus Clay debuted.
Yeah.
He's come back.
Yeah, 4 months of hype. It was
4 months?
4 months. Probably since around October that VP has been on his phone, you know, interim general manager of Raw has been on his phone and be like, Brutus will bring you in next week, I promise.
Hey, somebody called his mama, he's here. He's back. The man. Brutus Clay. Mm. Some people are so mad, some people are so happy, some people like it, some people hate it. Mm-hmm. What's your opinion?
Your dance accurately describes it. 4 months of hype for this. This is almost as bad as Jericho coming back and not talking.
You know, at first I hated Brutus Clay coming back.
Yeah.
Or like, not that he came back, but just that, like, you know, he came back as this like joke gimmick, you know, kind of deal. And Brutus Clay could be a monster heel. But then I started thinking, who would Brutus Clay, what would you have done if differently, you know? How else would you have brought Brutus Clay back?
Well, definitely not as a joke. I mean, he came back as a joke. If you're going to hype someone for 4 months, at least bring him back credible. Because when he came out, either the whole audience hadn't heard of Brutus Clay, or when he came out, they were disappointed because the crowd had no pulse.
Well, I mean, you know, it was Brutus Clay. It's his... He hadn't been in very long. He just came in with... He had a thing with Alberto Del Rio, and now he's coming back. And so, you know, what do you expect?
I expect people... I mean, granted, the crowd was terrible. The entire Raw crowd was awful. But I still expect a little bit of reactions, you know. After months... You know, the ring announcer said it. After months of hype, he's making his debut on Raw. And the minute I heard from Planet Funk, I knew that it was just going to be terrible. Get out of here with that.
So... Here's my thing. In the Golden Era, who'd you have? You had someone like a Dusty Rhodes. In the Attitude Era, you had Grandmaster Sexay, you had Rikishi, had Scotty Too Hotty. You know what? In all the thriving, whenever WWE thrives, they always have some kind of, all these different kind of characters you can get behind. And you know what? Some of them are fun, some of them are serious, some of them are great in-ring workers, some of them are just weird, stupid, funny gimmicks that you get behind and you just enjoy watching every week.
But I'm really sure, I'm almost 100% positive, that Dusty Rhodes or Too Cool to Tag Team didn't have 4 months of hype behind them.
Hey, gotta do
something. It fell WWE style flat on its face. Just terrible.
It just seems like they're doing something right with Brutus Clay at this point because, you know, they made a big deal out of him.
I would rather him not come back if he's going to come back and be, you know, the fatter version of Santino Marella, because that's what he's going to end up being.
Well, I mean, eventually he might, you know, end up kind of being a jobber, but so does every Joe gimmick. But you know what? I would rather that happen than him become Mark Henry jobber, because eventually Brutus Clay, if, you know, he has very short, actual span of getting. He's not likely to get in, you know.
Yeah.
He has very short likelihood of actually getting into that main event, and so unless he's going to either be pushed as a main eventer, he needs to either be he's going to be a jobber of some kind, a main mid card jobber.
If you're moving Dolph Ziggler towards the main event card, you know, like they're trying to do, it seems like,
Then
why don't you have him replace Dolph Ziggler on the mid card for when Zack Ryder finally, you know, wears off the fans? Now that he has the title, what do the fans have to cheer Zack Ryder for? He's really annoying. You know, he's not really a man, apparently.
Hey, a lot of people like Zack Ryder.
Not me.
But, you know, we need some kind of funny thing that we can kind of take our minds off. You know,
the entire Raw is a joke at this point. The entire WWE is sort of a joke at this point because the World Heavyweight Champion isn't credible. He's not credible. The WWE Champion, I mean, CM Punk's fine. You know, he wins in good matches. They only have, like, three titles on Raw, and one of them is the tag team titles.
Yeah. Well, in other news, Brutus Clay's back.
That's not another news. That's the main news.
Still, nonetheless, I'm just saying he is going to be
a jobber.
He's going to be, you know, something different in WWE. He's going to be something. He's going to bring a little bit of contrast, and he's going to be, you know, something fun that you don't have to just sit there and think about, like, you know, with Jericho. It's like, is he, you know?
Oh, somebody acting goofy. That's gonna bring contrast.
Well, okay, and it's gonna be fun. Unlike Santino Morella, where it's just like, all right, we get it, trumpets, you know. Santino's worn out his welcome, and now he's just like a jobber, you know. And it's not funny anymore. Hornswoggle is just absolutely ridiculous. And
I would rather let the record show. I would rather have Hornswoggle in a match than Brodus Clay. Seriously, you don't have to dance around for 5 minutes. You know, he better not dance around for as long as he did tonight. It's like the Godfather had sex with, who was that? Grandmaster Sexy. And it's like he had sex with Too Cool, and then Dusty Rhodes walked in and got a little too excited. And that formed the Brodus Clay gimmick. I swear, if he dances again for 5 minutes, I'm going to rage, dude.
Hey, you know, okay, I'd much rather see this than in the PGR than, I don't know, just boring Batista, John Cena, Randy Orton over and over and over and over and over again, you know. Let's see a little bit of, you know, of the guys like CM Punk, and we'll see, you know, a guy like Dolph Ziggler and, you know, them compete, and then we can see people like Brodus Clay, who's actually looks like a credible contender. He looks like he could really, you know, beat the crap out of somebody. And so why not have someone that's believable be kind of in a fun position where people can get behind him and enjoy it?
Brodus Clay is going to end up like Val Venus later in his career.
Ugh, like Val Venus.
How he took forever to come out, do a little towel intro, then he's going to come out and like lose in a 2 minute match. And eventually it's going to wear on the fans' nerves. Brodus, could this be one of the biggest failures in WWE marketing?
And the answer is no.
There's not even any contrast. You know, you're not bringing 4 months of hype, and we get a joke gimmick.
Hey,
4 months of hype. Four months of bring back Brodus Clay, and we get a joke gimmick.
Initially, I was so like shocked. Like I, you know, hadn't heard anything about this. I was like kind of mad, and then I rewatched it. And I was like, you know, what's there to be mad about? I enjoy this. I don't want to see Mark Henry 2.0. Sorry, you know.
You don't have to have Mark Henry 2.0.
I don't want to see white Mark Henry. There's not a lot you can do with a Brodus Clay. And so, you know what? Comment, rate, subscribe. Let us know what you think. Subscribe to High Five Wrestling. Subscribe to the Gurus of Greatness.
So, I mean, you're just going to say that it's a good gimmick. Okay.
Yeah, enjoy it. No, you know? Don't overanalyze it because, you know.
It's such garbage.
You know, internet fans are never content. Why not just be happy? Just enjoy what we have.
You wouldn't be happy if you won the Royal Rumble. You would not be happy if you won.
No, he shouldn't win the Royal Rumble. He just came back. And he's not. He's
not. I'm talking about next year. You wouldn't be happy if you won the Royal Rumble.
If Brooke booked really properly.
Maybe. You can't book a gimmick like that properly.
Well, we'll see.
No, you'll see that he ends up being a Santino Morella-style jobber, right, except heavier.
In conclusion, haters gonna hate. Somebody call his mama.
The entire...
We'll high-five you later. Because in reality, we're great.
Not gonna high five you.
Somebody call my mama.
Terrible. Somebody.